The Tillingbourne, only 11 miles long, is ideal for water power. There were mills of every conceivable type, flour mills, paper mills, and even gunpowder mills. The steam engine changed all that, and only a few mills still stand. None are working. But there is one water wheel still in use. These cottages at Abinger Hammer have no main supply. The Tillingbourne is pure and drinkable, but it's below them and needs pumping uphill.
In this hut here, there's a big water wheel about 10 foot across it, which drives off the Tillingbourne stream. As far as we know, this is only working pump reindeer for miles. I don't know of anybody else working a pump or even a wheel to do any work. So I can remember the old Gumpshire one going. I suppose that was about in the 30s. They used to grind flour and all down there. About 1864, it was installed here. But we can't find no maker's name on it, so we don't know who made it. It's been going ever since, and of course we have to do the bits and pieces to it, and, you know, buckets and washers and that on the pump. It's very efficient, really, because, I mean, it pumps the water about a mile up to a big reservoir, and it's siphoned back to the cottages.